Good morning, Monomoy. As you can see, with the conditions that we are currently under, we won't be able to be getting into the studio right now, but we have created a new format for Monomoy in the Morning, which will include some different segments, and we plan on producing these every 2 weeks. So, hope you enjoy them. Stay healthy and wash your hands.
Good morning, Monomoy. I hope that your quarantine has been well so far. So there's no sports to discuss, so Trevor and I will be doing music reviews and movie reviews weekly. The first album we're reviewing is After Hours by The Weeknd, which is the number one album in the world. Sold 425K the first week. So it's been a huge hit so far, commercial success-wise, and it's obviously was built up through a lot of hype. So if you're looking for some R&B, some soul, some 80s synth music, some rap, some alternative music, it's the album for you. It has, all of it wrapped up in one album. So yeah, a lot of, he uses a lot of his like synth music to kind of have that Michael Jackson vibe to it. But there's also some darker tone songs on there, so like Alone Again. Too Late, Faith, Until I Bleed Out. Those are some more darker tone songs. There's also like uplifting songs like Blinding Lights, In Your Eyes.
I don't ever wanna know. I could tell what you've done, yeah. When I look at you in your eyes.
So yeah, there's some songs for everybody on the album. I'll give it a listen. I have plenty of time to listen to music, obviously, so I would give it a listen definitely, and I'd rate it an 8 out of 10 probably. 8 out of 10, maybe 7.5 out of 10. I don't think it's Beacon's best album, but I would say it's one of his best. And I think there's a deluxe version coming, so listen, get ready for that if that comes. There might be some more songs on there, so all right, that's it for the review. And now we're gonna go to Trevor with his movie review. I don't know what he's doing yet, but it should be great, obviously. It's Trevor Russell, so we'll see what he does.
Thanks, Noah. I'm Trevor, and today I'll be bringing you a brief movie review. The movie that I'll be reviewing is Batman: The Dark Knight. I just finished watching Batman: The Dark Knight, and I thought that it was an excellent movie. The Joker in the movie, played by Heath Ledger, is my favorite Joker that I've ever seen. After watching all of the trilogy of the new Batman movies and also the new Joker movie, I feel that this Joker really embodies the Joker better than any of the other ones. I also thought that Batman, this movie, played by Christian Bale, is an amazing character and he does a really good job embodying him. This movie is definitely one of my favorite movies, and I'm glad to have watched it.
All right, what's up, Monomoy? It's Liam here, the weather guy. If you're like me and have felt a little trapped in your room the past 2 weeks, you're missing that social interaction you used to have. It's to give you guys some fun things to be doing while you're in quarantine so that you're not bored. Today, I'm going to be introducing something called Netflix Party, which is like a Chrome extension. Really download on the App Store or whatever. It's super easy, and once you download it, you just open up your Netflix account. It should be up in the top right of your screen, the extension that you downloaded. And that way you'll be able to actually sync up your the movie or show that you're watching with a friend and be able to chat on the side at the exact same time about the film you were watching. So it's super cool, super easy, and completely free. That way you still get to be like watching a movie with friends, but you're not actually leaving your house. Social distancing. All right, well that's it for today. That's Netflix Party. First number one of the things to do while you're bored in quarantine. See you guys next time.
Hey everyone, it's Liv Hayden. Because of everything going on in the world right now, I'm here to share another piece of good news to put a smile on your face. Because of statewide shutdowns, many animal shelters have been forced to close, but many humane societies have reached out to social media for help. They've been able to get over 500 applications from families to become emergency fosters. And a California shelter hosted a drive-through adoption day where families would drive up and then be able to leave with a foster pet along with the supplies to take care of them. More than 100 pets found a new home by the end of the week, and other shelters are following in their footsteps. Stay positive, everyone. Now to Abby J with some good food.
Good morning, Monomoy. So today is Cooking with Abby J. I'm gonna be making a bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel. I'm so excited, I'm so pumped. Like, this is just a classic, easy quarantine snack. I know you got eggs, I know you got bread. Come on, guys. So if you wanna know how to cook a bomb bacon, egg, and cheese on a bagel, keep watching. Let's get started.
So you're gonna need cheese, bagel, bacon, butter, eggs, a little bit of milk, and then set up 3 pans on medium heat. Start off by putting oil in the first pan, and then take a little bacon and put it in the pan and just let it sizzle. 1 tablespoon in the first pan, crack 2 eggs and add a little bit of milk and whisk it together, and then pour it into that pan after the butter has been melted. Then take the other tablespoon of butter and cut your bagel in half, and as the butter is melting, submerge it all in the butter and just let it grill on the pan, along with your bacon and eggs. Flip your bacon every once in a while until you hear this. Check on your eggs and your bagel until it's grilled to the way you like it. I'm adding sliced and sprinkled cheese, and then I'm just making my egg into this one big plop. I'm adding these spices and I'm putting it on my bagel. Wow, that looks so good. I'm gonna add some cheese in the bacon. Oh my goodness. I'm deciding to add an extra kick of hot sauce and ketchup, and it's ready to eat.
Immaculate.
Thank you guys for tuning in.
That sandwich literally made me so full. The cheese overload. I really hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.
I'm Maddie, and I'm going to be showing you how to make Italian bread for an easy quarantine snack.
First, we are going to take out a mixer and a dough hook. We get a cup of water at about 115 degrees and put it in. We then add 1 teaspoon of sugar into the 115 degree water and mix it around.
Next, we'll add 2 1/4 teaspoons of active dry yeast into this water and sugar mix. We now have to proof the yeast for 10 minutes, which basically means just let it sit in the mixture.
So right now the yeast is eating the sugar and growing, and you'll be able to see its size change. So we just added a cup of flour and a tablespoon of olive oil, and then a teaspoon of salt.
And you have to put the flour in before you put the salt so the salt doesn't kill the yeast. Now we will slowly add more flour until we reach 2.5 cups. We add all the flour in, we will grease the pan, and then now we will turn the speed higher to knead the dough for 4 minutes.
Now we're just gonna let this sit for 45 minutes to rise. We're gonna put a warm, wet towel on it to keep the dough moist. Once the dough has risen for 45 minutes, we then are gonna transfer it into the bread pan and let it rise for 40 more minutes. Now we will put the bread in the oven at 375 for about 20 minutes.
Hi guys, my name is Jason Morrison, and this is the start of a new segment on ways to pass the time. It will be primarily about video games, specifically ones you can play by yourself or with friends. This first game is Animal Crossing New Horizons, a game with relaxing gameplay and new stuff to discover every day. Unfortunately, this game is only accessible by Nintendo Switch, so if you have a Switch, I highly recommend you pick up this game. I'll have another game suggestion next week for those without Nintendo Switches or who don't think this game is for them. Thanks for watching, Monomoy, and have a great week.
Hey guys, so I got back from the NAC. I got an avocado burger and french fries. Helen, what did you get?
Hamburger.
We had to order online. We just parked at a beach and we ate our food in the car. Can't really do much today because it's raining, so now we're at Stop and Shop. So I just got back from Stop and Shop. There's actually a lot of people. You're not allowed to bring your own bags. Apparently it's like a state ban, and a lot of people were wearing gloves and masks. Okay, thanks, bye guys.
Hey guys, Joseph here. Usually I would do this on a better set, but at the moment there isn't really any great spots to do it. But today I decided to add on with the segment. So I'm doing the quarantine movie of the day. So the quarantine movie of the day is a classic, Contagion. Matt Damon, Gwyneth Paltrow, Kate Winslet, Jude Law, you know, pretty much, it kind of shows what's going on or what could happen.
It's transmission, so we just need to know
with what we're experiencing currently.
There were two people.
Obviously in a more extreme way, but it shows like what would happen if it did get more insane. It's a good movie to watch, and I suggest you check it out.